Hey, this is Nat, and we're off our couch in the oldest city in America, St. Augustine, Florida. But today, we're not here to talk about this city's extensive history, and we're not covering the impressive array of delicious food available that we've discussed so extensively in some of our other videos. But today, we are here to enjoy the lively art scene that is present and thriving in this northeastern Floridian city. St. Augustine has numerous galleries all over, from the downtown historic district onto Anastasia Island and the beach. And on the first Friday of each month between 5 and 9 p.m., there is the First Friday Art Walk. The art walk happens all around St. Augustine since there are galleries all over St. Augustine, as I just mentioned. About 30 galleries participate in the monthly event, and we're going to focus our efforts right now within the downtown historic district. Many of the galleries are within walking distance of each other, but there is complimentary trolley service available on First Friday evenings. You'll just need to grab a sticker from a participating gallery to take advantage of a free trolley ride. We're super excited to check this out because we have enjoyed art walks in other cities, but this is our first in St. Augustine. What we love about art walks is that there's often wine and snacks during the event, and that's still the case in St. Augustine. We're beginning the evening walking on Avila Street, the oldest street in America, as we love to do, and sangria is being served at the Jimenez Facio House. The Jimenez Facio House is a museum that portrays the story of a boarding house owned and managed by women since the early 1830s. Every room has a story, so there are many historical stories that are brought to life during the tour of the museum. And we're learning about a new exhibit and tour named I Lived Here As Well, telling the story of the African Americans who lived and worked behind the scenes at this boarding house. Highly interesting. I can't wait to check it out. So the first gallery we're walking into is Plum Contemporary Gallery. Actually, there's going to be a bit of a delay because there's wine available for a donation to support the arts. That is a win-win. So after enjoying some wine, we can now enter the gallery. Plum Contemporary Gallery showcases local and regional artists that offer both original and unique pieces. The space here is so bright and welcoming, which allows the art to really stand out and animate the room. This gallery proudly displays fascinating decor, incredible artwork, and absolutely stunning jewelry. And I love so many of the earrings and bracelets at this table. They're just beautiful, and now I have my wish list completed. Anniversary, birthday, Christmas, Valentine's Day, all of those wish lists are filled in now. This is the first time we've had a chance to make it in to Plum Contemporary Gallery and browse all of the magnificent art, jewelry, and apparel. So glad we got to drop in, and we're walking into Jensen Pottery now. This is another first visit for us. Jensen Pottery features the work of Ken Jensen and Donna McCarthy Jensen. Jensen Pottery offers stoneware that is all microwave and dishwasher safe, and these fantastic, interesting pieces that are musical instruments made from pottery, horns, drums, guitars, and more. My first thought was that these were for decorative purposes only, but no, these are not just visually appealing, they are functional as well, as creator Ken Jensen demonstrates. I bet you recognize both of those tunes, but I'm also going to bet that you have never seen or heard them played on such a colorful and uniquely shaped horn or a turtle-shaped whistle, both produced from a potter's wheel. Amazing, isn't it? What an awesome conversational piece to have in the home. And within Jensen Pottery, there is also the work of Donna McCarthy Jensen, whose love of the human form is expressed in the sculptures of dancers and figures gracefully holding yoga poses. Such an astounding variety of pieces to choose to take home and enjoy in your own personal space. Our next stop this evening is Georgia Knit Gallery, and we are familiar with the various art offered at this gallery. We've had the opportunity to visit on other occasions, but this is our first time being here for Art Walk. So this is really exciting. Visiting artists are here tonight, and we're enjoying all of the energy in this creative space. Georgia Knit Gallery features artists from Florida's First Coast. At this gallery, you'll find original fine art, stained and painted glass, books, sterling silver jewelry, leather goods, and more. As I stated before, when we visited this gallery on our tour of Avila Street, the oldest street in America, there is something for practically every interest here. And to discover more about this gallery, check out the link to our visit and tour of Avila Street in the description box. In addition to all the incredible art and goods that can be found at the Georgia Knit Gallery, I have also discovered the snack table. I'm being told by the owner it's a little different from past art walls. We're wearing our masks within the gallery, so it's a grab-and-go snack, which is perfect as we make our way to the Professional Artists of St. Augustine Gallery. I imagine you all saw the acronym and thought we were about to indulge ourselves at one of the many outstanding restaurants here in St. Augustine. But no, we're not being distracted. We're staying focused on the art tonight. The only distractions are the wine and the snacks that we come across. And our attention is fully engrossed on what we're taking in because this is the oldest fine art gallery in St. Augustine. Established in 1982, Professional Artists of St. Augustine proudly displays works from local artists creating oil, acrylic, and watercolor paintings, photography, stained glass, and lots more. And since it's art walk, there are drinks and snacks available to munch on. There are just so many striking pieces to gawk at. You'll be browsing and shopping in this gallery for some time, and there are still a lot of art galleries to see, so it's great to enjoy a snack or two between the galleries. So we're going to head to George Street and check out Sea Spirits Gallery. And at Sea Spirits Gallery and Gifts, the art, the jewelry, the blown glass, the decor, the treasures within the gallery, all inspired by the sea. That sounds inspiring and beautiful, and it is. The colors, the subject matters, and the styles of these pieces are attention-grabbing. And this jewelry, my wish list has just magically grown, doubled actually, just like that. These pieces, the jewelry, the artwork, and the decor speak to me visually and emotionally. I love the water, so I am in tune with the inspiration that shapes these pieces. And directly next door is the Lost Art Gallery. At this superb gallery, art from around the world, including art from the 17th to 19th century masters like Rembrandt, Degas, and Renoir are on display. In addition to being in the presence of these masters, there are also works from contemporary masters available for sale, such as Salvador Dali and Keith Haring. Lost Art Gallery's mission is to offer a selection that has something for everyone. So when you visit this beautiful gallery, you'll also come across a wide range of contemporary and regional artists. In addition to art, the works of internationally recognized photographers are available. A walk through this gallery is an immersion and education into the world of art. And all of our questions have been answered insightfully by Alex, who manages the family-owned gallery and appraises many of these original works. His love and knowledge of art is evident in the way he greets visitors of the gallery and discusses those pieces within the gallery. So our final gallery we're visiting this evening is across from the Leitner Museum on Granada Street. Although all of the galleries we visited tonight have art in common, they're all different and have their own distinctive flair. The same is true for Sweetwater Coffee Bar and Gallery. As you can tell by the name, it is a coffee bar, it is an art gallery, and it's also a place that hosts paint parties, which we think is really cool. This gallery consists of the work of a mother and daughter team. They produce vivid and colorful fine art oil paintings in all different sizes. The studio walls are lined with a myriad of bright and artistic original creations from the back all the way to the front where the coffee bar is, which means after you pick up a coffee, lemonade, bagel, sandwich, or salad, you can have a seat and enjoy a meal surrounded by all of this wonderful art. And Sweetwater Coffee Bar and Gallery also has outdoor seating, so choose your scenery, take in the beautiful surroundings, and enjoy. Well, we have definitely enjoyed. It's been such a great experience to be able to explore this dynamic art community and the nation's oldest city. And there's more, lots more to see. And during the First Friday Art Walks, it's so easy to see even more of the participating galleries. As I mentioned earlier, there is complimentary wheelchair accessible trolley service between 6 and 9 p.m. The shuttle stops on King Street, Avila Street, Cathedral Place, and Hippolyta Street. At each stop, open galleries are announced, so you can hop on and off and partake in so many of these galleries. You only need to pick up a sticker from a participating gallery in order to ride the trolley for free. Also, parking downtown is free after 5 p.m. And additional free parking is available at San Sebastian Winery. So this is a free event to enjoy while in the ancient city. It is important to note that the complimentary trolley transportation is not available during Nights of Lights, St. Augustine's annual award-winning holiday lights display. So the free trolley rides are not available during the December or January First Friday Art Walks. Yet the holiday time period is still a great time to go, as is any First Friday. It's really an awesome event with awe-inspiring art and friendly people. We can't recommend this monthly artistic collaboration enough. We truly hope you can make it to a First Friday event soon. And if you've already checked it out, let us know all about your experience. We hope you like this video. If so, please hit the like button, subscribe, and continue exploring and traveling with us as we discover more of Florida and other destinations. For all our subscribers already on the journey with us, thank you so much. We love the company, and we appreciate all of the shares, likes, and comments. Thank you. Click on the notification bell so you don't miss any new content, and click on the video to see another one of our experiences. Thanks for watching.